Da muss ich keine Karte nehmen. Jetzt schon. Oh. The end of Modern Family.
Is it on? Can you hear us? Yep.
Oh. I forget we can watch it on our TV.
And ready? Hey, everybody. Welcome. This is the
Christian
and Daniel Show. How's everybody doing? Happy Wednesday. It's 7:30 p.m. Wednesday night. Thank you for joining us. How you doing, babe?
I'm doing okay. I'm still trying to get used to looking at the camera.
I feel like I haven't seen you, but I haven't seen you since Monday, really.
I know. He abandoned me. He left me with no food, no water. I'm like, okay, I don't even have water to drink right now.
I left him in the car with the window cracked and a bottle of water. And
that no was, water.
No water.
He left me with like some dried up old juice that was on the all-weather mat, the bottom of the thing. I tried to lick it, but I got sick. So I said, okay, I can't do this.
Well, anymore. I've tried to leave you out in the field somewhere, but you always sniff your way back.
I'm like, yeah, I'm that dog that just finds its way home. What is it? Coming home, going home, whatever those movies are about. I'm that old dog who you just can't get rid of.
There we go. Hey, everybody. So I hope you guys are doing well. We didn't even talk about what we're going to talk about today. We just kind of...
No, that's what we do.
Well, I know, but usually we like kind of like, okay, so what's going on this week?
Just being spontaneous. Like, this week's been interesting. I just got to mention, I've been like waiting for a package all day.
Oh.
So that I was told in a very panic. Well, I was just told in the fashion that it was very urgent and that it was going to arrive today. And it never got here. It's like, well, I'll say it still isn't here. I don't know how late UPS delivers, but it's kind of weird. Just, it was a lot of energy put behind something for something that didn't really show up. And I wasn't given a tracking number or anything. So I have no way of knowing where it's at or when it's coming. But I know with what's going on with the pandemic that stuff's getting delayed. Nothing's really getting anywhere like it's supposed to.
We're going to lose over a little bit.
So I just continue to have faith that it will arrive.
For some reason, our Facebook page where we do live is kind of acting up a little bit. But no, I am not the face of Olaf. Stella said her daughter thought I was the voice of Olaf. But no, I'm not. I'm not the voice of Olaf. And they're liking your face. She says she loves your faces, Christian.
Oh.
I do too. In the dark. Okay. So we mentioned this last week.
Okay.
We
are fully addicted
to TikTok.
And we know we're way behind the wheel on this, but I'm 50 years old.
But
that happens.
Because I've spent a couple of hours a night on TikTok. A lot of people are like new to TikTok, especially older folks.
And particularly with like, yeah, well, bottom line, like people in my age group, which to your daughter would be old folks. I didn't even know what TikTok was till like we were at the quinceañera and you mentioned it. And I still didn't know what it was. Like, I didn't comprehend what it was. I was just like, what's TikTok? I've never heard of TikTok. What is TikTok? Is it like a clock someone just watches and it's fun? And Daniel's like, oh my Lord, you're so old. And he didn't explain it to me because it was the quinceañera. And then a couple months later, here we are in quarantine and I'm like, na 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 na, na 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 na. I love Daniel so much, but I need more input. And he mentions download TikTok. He mentioned TikTok, and I go, ugh.
Well, I kept showing you my videos. It's like, for instance, this is my phone, and I'll be watching a video, and of course, I had to do some videos, and I'm like, look. And then if you don't understand, like, it's, yes, there's dance challenges, but there's
so much more.
There's a lot of sound bites, and what you do is you hit record, and you lip sync or lip speak.
You lip sync.
You lip speak.
Lip sync. It doesn't have to be singing.
to the TikTok video. And there's one about the corona. There's one about
everything is okay.
That was the first one I did.
That's a really funny one.
But there's the one about this year, Cinco de Mayo and Taco Tuesday both fall on Tuesday, and how sad that it's being killed by a Mexican beer. So anyway, you have to go see my TikTok. You have to go see it. And
no self-promotion.
No, not at all. Oh, but it's reached like 14,000 likes.
Oh, that reminds me. There's something.
And like 160,000. Like, it's
of really all popular the video. Video he's done. I don't know why that one took off. I don't get it. I don't know why, but it took off like it's a skyrocket. It's huge. It's almost, it's not viral.
Yes.
But it's just crazy that it went.
Yeah. Maricruz, no habla español. Poquito. Hablo poquito español. Si Maricruz from Monterrey is asking if you speak Spanish.
Sí.
So say hi to Maricruz.
Hola, Maricruz.
And
I'm very good at monkey see, monkey do. If he says this a way, I could try and say it as close to it as I can.
He tries to get the R's.
Oh, I can't roll
being
R's.
From Monterrey, we roll R the R's, you know. But yeah, so
I sound like a car dying car. Blah, blah.
So if you're watching and you have a TikTok page, will you post it in our links and I can upfollow you and like your videos and we can like each other?
Yeah.
But we did a couple of videos before we went to bed.
There's one that I love, but I can't say it on here because it has cussing in it.
Yeah.
But it's about someone saying, I really don't like you.
Yes.
I really don't like you.
And the sad thing is there's more to that video and
we didn't know. We didn't get the original, which we now know always go to the original. Because then you get the whole thing. Because there was more to it. That's where that little.
So we can do the PG version of it.
Yeah.
So it starts with you.
I go, I freaking hate you.
What?
I said, I freaking hate you.
You hate me?
Yes.
Wait.
And then he goes, I don't give a darn.
So that's the PG version.
That's a very PG version.
But I was, and then I did a video. Well, there's this big thing right now within the HIV community talking about anxiety and depression. And for those of you that don't know, I do suffer from agoraphobia, social anxiety. So I did a video, like a PSA for it. So if you guys get a chance to see it, check it out.
Well,
it's all over.
One of the big things is that there's so many people that are, now that we're testing, of course, we're going to see a huge burst in the number of people infected with COVID-19. And we're going to see this huge influx. And what's interesting is Daniel and his group of people who, Healthy Voices, who have, you know, these are long-term HIV survivors, and they've had other diseases. Like Daniel's also had anal cancer and survived that, and many other things have gone on. That they understand the survivor or being infected and the psychology that goes with that. Because I don't think people have really addressed the fact that people with COVID-19, it's going to affect you like any other disease you're being told you have. It separates you. And there could be shame. There could be any number of things that will go with it, emotions. And it doesn't seem like anyone's really addressing that yet. Well, we have an entire population of people who've already gone through that, who've gone through this for decades at this point and are experts in how to recover through this. And that's what Daniel's group is trying to do, is they're trying to put out there that you don't have to be ashamed. You don't have to be upset. You're not, it's not something you need to have as a negative. It's just something you need to survive.
Yeah. So for those of you that have been following me for a while, Healthy Voices is a conference that I go to once a year, put on by Jensen Pharmaceuticals. Great conference. It got postponed this year. It was supposed to be coming up soon. Positively Fearless, which is the campaign that I'm part of, which you can find them all online. We'll put the link later. Positivelyfearless.com. What are you cracking up about?
I'm giggling because I stifled a yawn while you were talking about that. And I felt so bad because it was so ill-timed. That's so bad. Every time we're on this, I get like 3 or 4 yawns during this thing, and I'm not bored at all or anything.
Do I bore you, Christian?
It's just.
Do I bore you?
Do you want me to tell you the trigger?
Why start now?
Why? Oh.
But yes, for Estella's daughter, I'll find you on TikTok later and follow you. For everybody who's joining us just now, this is the Christian and Daniel show. Thank you for joining us. And we're just having a discussion of what's going on in the week.
In our world.
If you'd like to share this on your page, feel free to do so. And just a half hour of fun and entertainment for you guys.
You know, my neighbor was telling me that there's this family she knew of that are effectively become homeless through this, which I don't think, again, there's so much that they're not addressing with this pandemic. And there's so much that I feel is being like, in order to keep society, mainstream society, calm and quiet, that it's being suppressed. Like the number of people who are losing, you know, you're not supposed to be able to get kicked out of your home right now or anything, but it's not like rent goes away. It's like you still have to pay the landlord back all the back rent you owe, no matter how, you know, as long as they're protected, you have protection and can't be kicked out. But I think people are forgetting there are landlords, there are people out there who are violating those rules of engagement and are just kicking people out when they say, like, if they're honest and go to them early and say, I'm not going to be able to pay you rent next month, they're like, well, then this is your notice. Yeah, and they'll do it to whole families. And this family in particular has children and mom and dad, and they've just run out of food. And Daniel and I Daniel was blessed with being able to go to a food pantry in very upscale Laguna Beach. And it, I mean, because the food he got was kind of upscale. It's like, not like you'd get in LA.
Basically, if you're able to help somebody out, help them out. You don't know what situation they are.
And we didn't know, but we ended up contributing to giving some fresh food and fresh fruit and vegetables and some cereal that you could eat dry.
But
I love dry cereal.
But Christian, talking about Laguna Beach, that is kind of funny though, because I've gone to other food pantries and you kind of get
we're
like
Laguna Beach.
Yeah, you go to a food pantry and I'm so blessed and I'm so grateful that there's places where we can get food because I'm out of a job right now too. I'm only working very selective things, but they gave us like queso fundido and this is like this really nice and wraps and I'm like, of course it's Laguna Beach. We're not gonna have like just any food pantry.
Yeah. It was nice. Some not really nice stuff. Estella, you're absolutely right. I can't add much more to it. You are absolutely right that they're suppressing the incredibly large numbers of Latinos, African Americans, and other some socially economically depressed minorities that are not being you're not being told the outrageous infection rates, mainly because of the lack of availability of supplies and effective plans for how to educate and how to keep you from getting ill.
So
these are so cool.
Speaking of people, like, you just don't know, our my friend Sandy in Laguna Beach.
Yes, who Michael. Is I have.
Who is who is God sent. She Sandy in Laguna Beach, Sandy St. John.
Who has a name like that? It's like an 80s.
Sandy St. John.
80s, what was that show? Falcon's Crest. Dynasty name. Yeah, that's
and
so amazing.
For anybody who lives in Orange County.
We love you, Sandy.
Especially in Laguna Beach, you know that she runs a lot.
She runs.
So she hooked us up with some masks. This is one of the masks.
Why don't you put that on and show them how to put it on properly?
Well, this is not the. Are you trying to shush me? Is that?
No, that's a odd one. That's the one that goes over your head.
Yeah.
And then you pull, and you spread this out because it's supposed to cover your eyes so you don't see where you're going.
I don't see no virus.
I won't get anything.
I don't see no virus.
This one's a little different than the ones that go around your ear, but it's the same concept. People forget. I know people are wearing these masks, both paper and cloth, and they're forgetting to pull them all the way open so that they cover down here and they go like they cover your nose more. A doctor, I saw it on TikTok. An actual doctor put one on and showed how to properly put it on. I didn't know you're supposed to pull it so there's no more folds. So I didn't know that.
I'm not sure who made these in Laguna Beach.
Beautiful.
I'll find out, but if anybody, I'll ask Sandy. Thank you for
we're so grateful.
We were able to get some for free. And
I've been using a ski earmuff thing and I learned how to turn it around so it would cover my mouth and my nose. But it's a thermal thing. So in today's weather, I was like dying. So when Daniel brought it over, I'm like, oh my God, thank goodness.
And I have like four bandanas in a bag in the bedroom. and I never told them where they were. So, I'm not. It's not a subliminal message or anything.
I wonder what that means.
It doesn't mean I don't want him. I mean, I want him to be safe.
Honey, when I'm in the hospital coughing, he's like, out of my lungs. He's like, I had a way to protect you, but I didn't tell you.
I'm
sure you'll feel better later.
You'll be coughing. I'm like, can you cover your mouth with this bandana?
Yeah. Once I'm already sick, can you please cover your mouth so I can get
God bless. But thank you for joining us. Again, this is the Christian and Dennis Show, a half hour of just conversations and fun. This is episode 10. I forgot to put out if you have any Dennis questions.
Our big episode 10.
This is 10 episodes.
I can't believe we've already done 10 episodes.
I know.
And we got theme music, which you can hear on YouTube.
Yes.
On YouTube, once this gets edited, and Daniel does his editing and adds it in, it's really great. We have a great thing called Thank You Again, Kai Kalama.
I wasn't saving that, but I think we've acknowledged the fact, and we can talk about this really quick, that I'm a very giving person. I'm really greedy and I'm really selfish.
Thank you. I would give every last cent.
Especially when it comes to, they were in the trunk.
Absolutely.
How dare you?
I love you, Tiffany.
How dare you?
Girl. They're not in the bedroom. They're actually out there in his car, which he just had.
When it comes to my food and my stuff,
Hi, Richard.
I am very greedy. I'm not greedy. I'm selfish. I look guilty.
No argument so far, and you should. You wish the window.
I don't like people eating it on my plate. I don't like.
He hid bandanas from me so that while he was gone in Laguna Beach, I was here walking in the polluted world, getting sick.
We've moved on.
I'm not sick. I don't have it. I'm just kidding. I'm not.
But okay,
but
well,
he
like
left
for instance,
me out in the wind. It's like leaving your baby in the backseat.
Okay, like the day we went grocery shopping. We talked about grocery shopping last week. We come back and we have a container of potato salad, and
OMG,
and it's for both of us.
I didn't know that because he doesn't usually eat potato salad.
But I bought a different one because I wanted. I don't like mustard potato salad. I don't like mustard potato salad. I like mayonnaise potato salad. And he went out of the container, and I almost jumped out of my shorts.
He essed a brick on the floor of the kitchen. And then I'm like, looking at him like this, like with the fork, I'm like, what? And he's all,
that's for both of us.
Like I was eating the whole thing. I scooped it in one big scoop. I'm just going to okay, that's it for the plain salad. I've ever done that.
I get crazy.
We've been together for
almost eight years.
We have been together for almost 8 years, and I take a bite of potato salad. That was done. He didn't eat the potato salad because I polluted it with Christian germs.
Robert just joined. Robert can tell you that it's... he probably knows.
No, and
it's,
all you said before, greedy.
I've always been that way. Like, I will buy you, I will make you something to eat.
And he didn't tell me that in advance. It's not like I'm like, cause I do. I'm like, it's just us, so I'll eat out of the container. It's not like we're going to share it with guests or something.
Same thing happened with the macaroni salad from the...
And I can't even stand.
The one that we, when we bought the Hawaiian food...
Oh,
the Japanese food. There were two scoops of macaroni salad.
Two scoop mac salad.
And he went to, and I'm like, but it's always, that's the first thing that jumps out of my mouth. That's for both of us.
Oh, like again. It's like it was a forkful. He keeps acting like I got the serving spoon out of the serving drawer and like scooped the whole scoop.
I feel like I just completely threw myself in the volcano here.
I'm like, are you kidding me?
Yes. Rick Wayne just posted a photo.
I was that's maybe Daniel. It's not me.
Oh, yes, sharing food. Yeah. Right, Robert? Right, yes.
It was separate food. These were separate mounds. It wasn't like it was.
There was okay. There,
the little thing he brought, the little container he brought, I thought was for me because the last one was for me, and he didn't touch it. Now he's of course. Well, I don't like mustard.
I don't like mustard potato salad.
And neither do I. It's not my favorite, but I'll still eat it because I like it.
But and this, and that, some friends learned this a while back. So we, a friend who is no longer a friend, we were out to dinner one night, and
it's not you, Maria.
No, and
since you just mentioned that, he doesn't mean to infer that.
No. A friend who is no longer our friend. You'll in this. Hold on.
I know. I'll get it.
And I tacos. Oh, I know. Tacos. And I love a Mexican Coke with my tacos. So I turned around and she grabbed my Coke and she goes, "Oh, can I have a little bit?" And she started pouring my Coke into her glass before I said yes.
And let me finish it. My sister in life, Martha, was there with me. And we're sitting across. We're sitting here. We're like here and here. And there's Daniel. And then Chola is across from us. And she does that. And our jaws dropped. Anyone who knows Daniel knows you do not, particularly Mexican Cokes, you do not mess with them. Okay, this is not the same situation. He's trying to do oranges to apples, but it's still a good example of how he is not a food sharer.
I looked over the across the table and I said,
I did enjoy the potato salad though, all to myself.
I looked across the table and I told her, "You can have the Coke." And she's like, "I just want a little drink." I'm like, "No.
Nope, you take it. I'll get another one."
You done violated.
He was so
my Mexican Coke.
Mad.
I will not touch it again.
Martha and I were like,
dying. Martha remembers. Martha just chimed in. She remembers.
Yeah. Martha, not, that's not Martha. That's Melinda.
No, down the bottom.
Martha. Oh, Martha. Yes. Oh, good. You're on. Yes, Martha. Our jaws dropped and we just sat there going, yeah. I think we talked about it for many weeks. Martha and I were like, I can't believe she did that.
The person.
Like, who does she think she is?
That didn't end the friendship, but eventually we were not friends anymore. So, but yes.
That, yeah. That's a whole nother story.
I can't believe, but
that'd
yeah.
be a whole nother half
so
hour.
So if you ever, once all this is over and we say, would you like to join us for dinner?
No, fair, Daniel will never let warning, you have anything.
I will buy you dinner. I will get you your own dinner.
You won't go hungry, but
no.
If you were starving and it was Daniel's plate of food that would keep you from starving, you'd die.
You know those like, yeah.
You'd be dead.
I'd be all like, yeah. I'd be all like Tiger King Tiger on you. If you,
I'd bite you like that tiger bit that he/she's arm off.
Like, don't let this suck.
I don't mean that as an insult. I honestly don't know how she identifies, so I said that way for that reason.
Yeah, it's funny now, but back then, oh my god!
He was so on the way home. He is with Martha and I, and he was just angry. It was unforgivable.
Even right now, I'm stewing in it.
And I'm getting sweaty. Sit next to him. His energy is just, woo.
But yes, if you and we've been to dinner with several people that are on online right now. You know, we will treat you to dinner. We will, whatever you want. But don't touch my food. Don't drink my Coke. Especially if it's a Mexican
drink
Coke.
My soda. Yeah.
Don't touch my Mexican Coke. And that is not code for anything, just don't touch it.
Yeah, it's like exactly that.
Anyway.
I like this.
This is nice. So can I brag?
Oh my lord. If we didn't do this, the show would not work.
So I want to
basically it's saying Daniel is a pain and living with him.
Yeah, you were gonna go.
It's my magazine. No, I'm just kidding.
So I want to send a big hi to Ken and Barbie.
Ken and Barbie Taylor, in lovely Arizona.
With the iPaint Foundation who
and
honored me, and I am so blessed to have people like them. Yes, but you know what? We talked about this.
Your hands
that,
on your face.
That the my face will forever be associated with the coronavirus
a drug
issue of this year. Thank
I
you.
Love it.
I want to also so Ken and Barbie Taylor from iPaint Foundation. Thank you for giving me this honor of being on the cover of your magazine. I want to shout out to Richard Wayne Kilgo
who took the picture.
He is the photographer.
He's amazing.
Not only was it my first cover, but it was his first cover as a photographer. So I'm very proud for both of us. And we're going to celebrate at.
Absolutely.
Yeah,
we will. We will.
I have 10 copies.
We only have a stack of them. So we're not sure how long this one will last.
I have 10 copies sitting. So anybody in the area, I will give you another
copy.
We
need
copy.
To get one to Wayne.
Yes,
too.
Yes. Wayne ordered his.
Oh, good.
Yes, I had one for him to surprise him, but he got it before I could do it.
Surprise.
Yes, Maddie, we'll get you a copy. and we'll put the link on at the end.
No, congratulations to you, Wayne.
Right at the very end, I will put the link. So if you want to order your own copy, you can do so. But thank you.
And you have your very own magazine with Daniel's face
yes.
on it.
Yes. you know you want that. You know, look at this face. It's a face only a mother can love. but don't touch my Coke. Just a day. Picks of the week.
Yeah.
What's your pick of the week?
My pick of the week was the final episode, which was very tearful, of Modern Family. That was one of my favorite shows. And you don't even realize you're watching TV, but you don't, some shows you actually connect to because it just touches so many topics that went on in my life and particularly my childhood and some of the wacky relatives you have and wacky family members you have. And no matter how wacky and crazy they all were, at least when I was a kid, it always come back to we're all family and we're all linked and that's just how it is. Unfortunately, that did not hold true in the 21st century, but that's how it used to be when I was a kid. And I really loved that. And I love that this Modern Family was like just a window into all of our lives, all the craziness that happens in modern day families. Sure. So it was really sad to see the end of it. And the actors have grown up so much and come so far. And the writers, and they had an hour special before it that was focused more on the crew and how they all were a big family and how they did things in one take. They really were an outstanding group of people, and they became outstanding doing that show.
I can only pray that I get a chance as an actor to be on a show like that at some point.
Then you'd see a cliff behind us with the sun setting and the ocean. Not green. It would be beautiful. And maybe our house staff walking behind us.
Because we would have staff. My pick of the week is, for anybody who remembers One Day at a Time from the 70s, if you didn't know, Netflix brought it back three years ago. One Day at a Time. So they did the reboot, and the reboot is actually a Latina family. They're from Cuba. Rita Moreno plays the grandmother.
Yes, Rita.
And I just forgot the name of the actress that plays the mom, but it's a divorced mom with Rita Moreno as the grandmother, the two kids.
Just really good stuff.
There's LGBT issues. There's immigration issues. I just watched up to episode two. There's three seasons. I'm sorry, season two. There's three seasons.
I've watched them all.
Season three just came out recently. So if you haven't watched it, yeah, it wasn't long ago because it was only, they weren't renewed for episode three. And then there was this huge campaign that went on that I signed the petition.
To get season
three. And season three came back. And so if you have not seen it, I'm not going to spoil anything, but if you have seen it, the end.
Yes, Madeline, finally.
The last episode of season two.
Tearjerker.
My God, I was sitting on my couch bawling. This week's picks.
You were bawling.
Are both family shows, so go check it out. And if you're not familiar with Modern Family, you can go to Hulu and find the episodes on there. So go check it out.
Yeah, and I'll tell you, One Day at a Time, this reboot was fantastic and is fantastic. I hope they keep getting support so they can keep making new seasons because it's pretty incredible. I know. And is Inara with you? If she is, hey, girl, how you doing?
And
we saw your most recent picture. Are you you a full-grown woman now?
You know,
Daniel, got all teary-eyed. He was like, I can't believe how big she is now. She's not a little girl anymore.
You know,
Welcome to the 21st century.
I know we're running out of time, but we're going to keep going for a little bit longer if you guys want to stick around.
Just a couple minutes.
It's hard to believe. I just posted on YouTube, on Facebook. I just posted on Facebook for those of you that saw and commented on it. That I posted the first picture that Christian and I ever took together, which was at my 42nd birthday.
42nd? Yeah. Pretty close.
So it was the first time that
it was my 22nd birthday.
She's baking. Why?
Oh my Lord, she's such a good baker.
Inara, Madeline's daughter, is an awesome baker. She's baked cakes for both of us for our birthdays.
We've really been blessed with seeing, we got to see your wonderful grandniece, Alexa, when we first started going out to Texas. When I first met her, she's just a little girl. And now she's a woman.
Well, that's what I was going to say. We've been together 8 years.
And Ava, Nancy Jr.
This May 9th will actually be Eight years that we met. So the picture that you guys commented on was the first picture we actually took together.
Ever.
But,
and of course, had that weird blue hue, which was weird.
I don't know where that was from. All the pictures that night had blue hue. But our meeting anniversary is May 9th.
Yes.
Of 2012. That's when we officially met. So we've had friends together with children all this time. And so that's 8 years that we've seen a lot of these kids grow
go
up.
Go from little kids to and being adults, or young adults.
There's Anara. There's...
who was a little girl when we met.
There's David and Nicole's
David
kids.
And Nicole's three kids, who are Cameron, Cole, and Chase. They were... I was there when Chase was... I was there shortly after Chase was born, because when I met her, she threw up all over me. I love that story. She's such a sweetie. And then I was there when Cameron was... I was there right after Cameron was born and got to see that little infant come home. And she's an amazing young woman now who's almost ready. She's like getting on in high school. She's in her last couple of years of high school, which blows my mind. And she's this young, beautiful woman. And I keep thinking, my gosh, where does all the time go? How do these kids become adults or young adults so quickly?
And
when it's not quick at all.
although I know that it's like 2020 and everybody's all more open and welcoming, we still are old generation where...
We're Gen Xers.
Not everybody was open about a gay couple coming around.
Oh, my
children.
Lord. No, our world was really different when I was a kid.
I still had friends growing up in Texas that would not be comfortable me being around their kids because I was gay. And to be, as a couple, to be part of the lives of our friends' children, to me, and I'm sure for both of us, it means a whole lot. So we really
appreciate it. Does, you know, and I'll tell you, David and Nicole Brophy and the three kids, they're truly people I consider my family. And of course, the Ramonas family will always, you guys are all my family. Ramonas and Garzas and all the other names mixed in. You guys are Benavidez, everything. You guys are my family. But Dave, Nicole, and their three kids, they were the first people. David is just one of the first people I came out to. And he was like, I know, duh. Thanks. I love it when people do that.
Blind and deaf people.
Yeah, like small farm animals. new. And then, you know, David welcomed me into his life when he got married. He welcomed me into his life when he was dating Nicole. He's always been open and very respectful and never looked at me as his gay friend. At least I never felt that. And I just appreciate that so much from that family, because they basically adopted me. Because my family wasn't great. My mom was amazing. That's where I have to leave it. And so they are my family of choice too. And they are such a blessing in my life. I feel bad. It's been really hard for me to go up north. Like I still get teary-eyed thinking about it. Like I'm not ready to go up to Northern California yet, because the only time I used to go up there was to see my parents. So not
for,
there yet.
For those of you that don't know the story, his parents passed away a couple of years ago. So
last year.
2019.
My dad died in 2019.
Yeah, but your mom died in 2019.
Yeah, she died at the end of 2018 in December.
It just seems so long ago.
But it does. And but no, that's like what you're saying. Dave was like the first family that I felt like it was okay for me. Like, and this is how much homophobia I had internally. Was that I didn't feel like I should be around his kids because I was scared that they were going to think I was some weirdo pedophile, because so many people used to assume that about gay,
and then
gay men and women, and that's ridiculous. But
the last, one of the last trips to Texas that we got to babysit Levi, my nephew Robert,
so
my nephew Robert's son Levi Daniel, and I'm going to claim that it's after me. It's after my dad, but I'm claiming it. We got a chance to babysit him and take him shopping with us, and it was, oh my God, we were... Okay, I have to tell the story about Whataburger, because we went to go have lunch at Whataburger.
By the way, I hope next time we get a chance to go to Texas. I know it may not be in the near future, but when we can, I totally want to. We have to see Levi Robert.
So we take him shopping with us, and we end up like, let's go have lunch. We go to Whataburger, and he was like, what, 5 or 6 maybe at the time?
Five.
And we wanted to order for him, and I turned to him, and I'm like, what do you want? And he goes up to the register and he's like, hamburger,
nothing on it. Or no ketchup, nothing on it?
Yeah, I think it's like nothing, just bread and meat, if I believe. Or
yeah,
ketchup.
Yeah, I think he actually like even specified that because the girl's a little confused.
And I'm like, whatever he wants, just give it to him. But he is such a cool little dude.
He's like, he was so ahead of his time. Like, I've never been anywhere with a five-year-old. And I used to teach them. I've never been anywhere with a five-year-old who can just walk into a restaurant and order like that. And, like, I know exactly what I need, and I don't need you to do it.
But to us,
I just need you to pay.
We were able to be there and celebrate with him. Plain and dry. There you go. Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
We had it right.
Yeah, plain and dry.
Plain and dry.
And he's such a blessing. Like, that day with him was so incredible. We had so much fun. And we just appreciate that. We love our family.
So for people who ask us if we're ever going to have children, no. we just borrow people's children for the day, and then we spoil them and fill them up with sugar and return them.
Of course, and our the newest baby is
Mateo.
Mateo is
we're able to spoil him and he can talk back. We're babysitting.
Yeah, we are so gonna come when we go down. They're gonna take him out too for a day. Give mom a moment to breathe.
But he's one of the newest.
We know Marcy's a hard working mama.
So and she's a nurse too. So you can probably tell you yes. As soon as they can talk, you know I don't like kids that can't talk. I need them to talk back so I can teach them bad manners. So as soon as he's able to walk and talk and change his own diaper, then we're.
Change some diapers.
Because I don't do diapers.
I think using a toilet might be more qualifying.
But we love you guys. And Marcy is a nurse, so thank you.
And she's on the front lines, guys.
Our nephew, Robert, he does a job that requires him to be out there, too. So
you guys are heroes, guys. You're big time heroes.
We love you guys.
We love you.
We're running
out of time. Yes, Madeline, we have been blessed. We are very blessed to watch the ever beautiful Inara grow up. And you allowing us and welcoming me. You know, through Daniel into your lives, it's been such a blessing. So thank you. Oh, and tell Anthony we say hey too.
Yes.
Hey, Anthony.
We're ready.
Like your big old new boat.
We're ready to come up and be on the boat. I'm gonna get big shades and
a scarf
and a hat
and a scarf and a fur coat. He's just gonna sit in a chair on the deck, not saying a word, not helping in any way. Take me where there's sun. Take me where there's sun.
There's the breeze. Make it stop.
Can it not rock so much? Hello.
This water's wet.
Hello. Can you make the water dry, please?
I didn't know it was going to be so wet in this water. But thank you, guys.
It's funny, the video online is a couple minutes behind, so we get to watch ourselves
Silly. For those of you, I'm pulling the cards out. I'm really growing our Little Mexican Productions, a social enterprise company, up, and part of it is doing the readings. So I didn't do a reading group last Friday, but I will be back this Friday. So Friday, 6:00 p.m. Pacific Standard Time.
Same place.
Log in. Yes, same
place,
page.
Same chat channel.
Join me for an hour of readings. But I pulled out a card for us, and it's the pink color. It's rosa pink. And the pink color is let love in. So can you see that? There you go. It's no party. There you go. So let love in. So for all of us, I know that right now we feel like we should be giving and giving and giving and giving. And that's great, yes.
But we need to be receiving.
Yes, when somebody offers you, when somebody gives you, when somebody brings you, accept it. Right now, we're not in a space or a time to think that anything is a hand-me-down or they're being putting you down or it's freeloading. Sometimes we need to receive, and not necessarily material stuff, but space and time and care. If somebody
sometimes just a kind word is
if you know I've been thriving or if I've been going to the grocery store or something, saying hi to somebody, accept that hello. We need a little bit of, we can't physically express our love, but we can emotions, we can share that energy. So accept the energy that's coming your way, and it'll make you feel better. Don't just give, especially because I know there's a lot of moms on our page right now and a lot of dads, moms and dads. If somebody is willing to give you a hand at the moment, accept that. Again, not necessarily material stuff, but physical energy, just a kind word, reach out. And if somebody says, hey, call me, take their word for it, call them. So if you need to talk to people, let's send us a message. We'll be happy to talk to you guys.
Very true. Very true. And so, we can't wait to be able to come down, come up and go on that boat with you, you and Anthony and Anara. That would be wonderful.
But thank you for joining us. This has the Christian and Daniel Show. And remember,
I'm Christian.
And does that make me Daniel?
Thank you.
Does that make me Daniel?
Thank you.
With that, folks, we love you. Thank you for joining us. We hope we can bring you a little bit of laughter and get you out of your routine for a little bit. We'll see you here next Wednesday. Bye, guys.
Bye.